Today I'm going to talk about something that a lot of us have probably experienced. It's one of the biggest problems that any of us are going to run into in a narcissistic relationship, and that is devaluation. I'm going to talk about why this happens and what exactly is happening when we enter the dreaded devaluation stage of a narcissistic relationship. Welcome to Looking Behind the Mirror, where we explore narcissism and take our lives back as we make sense out of nonsense. As a quick disclaimer, everything I say is based on my opinions and my personal experiences. I'm not a professional, and if you're really struggling, I encourage you to seek professional help. I am providing links below for you. It's fairly well known that in a narcissistic relationship, there's a cycle. And it's the cycle of idealization and devaluation. This is usually what ends up destroying the relationship, is the devaluation phase. This can also be very confusing for victims of narcissistic abuse. From our perspective, this looks like a relationship that starts off great with someone that really likes us, that really enjoys our company, that can't get enough of us. Everything's going awesome. And then at some point in the relationship, this person that once adored us and hung on our every word and couldn't get enough of us suddenly seems kind of annoyed at everything we do. Almost seems like someone that despises us at times, that can't stand us, that can't find a good thing to say about us. And it's very disorienting, it's very confusing, and it's very, very hurtful. Because at this point in the relationship, we've probably become very emotionally invested. We probably still have the same positive feelings and emotional attachment to our narcissistic partner, whereas this person that we're now completely invested in suddenly seems to not be able to even stand to be around us at times. And it's really hard to understand why. And a lot of us will start to blame ourselves and try to find a solution and try to find a way to fix this. What I want to explain in this video is that first and foremost, this is not the abuse victim's fault. This is not your fault. If you are in a relationship with a pathologically narcissistic person, devaluation is inevitable. It will happen. And I'm going to explain why in this video, but I want people to understand that you did not do anything wrong. You did not do anything to cause this, and you also cannot fix it. To explain this very simply and sum it up, the main reason this happens is because of a narcissist's black and white thinking. Because everything is either all good or all bad. Narcissists assess the goodness of something like a light switch. It's either on or off. It's either good or bad. There are no gray areas. There are no imperfections that are allowed to be in a relationship without completely tainting the whole thing and rendering the whole thing worthless. You are not allowed to have any flaws, otherwise you are completely bad. If you are not 100% good, 100% flawless, there is no other option but to be 100% bad, 100% garbage. When you begin a relationship with a narcissistic individual, there are a lot of things that are happening that you can't see, that you don't really understand are happening. And this is because narcissists are always looking for something that can only be found within one's self, but from their outside environment. They expect you to fulfill emotional needs that really can only be met through a relationship with one's self. Or in other words, they expect you to do something that is impossible. Narcissists have a nagging emptiness. Some of them actually feel as though they're being pursued almost by an entity of some sort, or some kind of feeling or force that's going to swallow them whole, that's going to force them to face a terrifying reality that they don't want to look at, which is that they are worthless, that they are meaningless. And this is an overwhelming emptiness inside of them, and they are always looking for ways to fill this, and they don't know how to do it from within themselves. And almost all of them don't really have the courage to even try to even acknowledge that this exists. They are constantly looking outside of themselves for fulfillment. They are constantly looking to other people to validate their existence. When you enter into a relationship with a pathological narcissist, they expect you to fulfill this for them. they have a fantasy in their head that you are this perfect, magical being that's going to solve all their problems and that's going to make that horrible, empty feeling go away forever. In order for you to fulfill this fantasy, you have to be flawless. You have to be perfect. You have to be the fantasy that they already had in their head. And that's impossible. No human being on the planet can just magically already be this magical fantasy person that exists in someone else's head. You're going to be an autonomous human being with your own unique traits, your own personality, your own preferences, and your own weaknesses and your own flaws. Narcissists project a fantasy onto you when they meet you, and they pretend that you are this magical, perfect person. And as the relationship goes on, they will eventually be forced to recognize that you're a human being, that you have flaws, and that you aren't quite exactly this perfect fantasy magic person that they have in their head. And that's when devaluation happens. Part of what triggers devaluation is when the narcissist starts to feel that empty feeling again, or that feeling of worthlessness that you've unknowingly helped them avoid for a while. When reality starts to set in again, that's when they're going to take another look at you and feel as though you have failed them, and they are going to blame you for this feeling that is always going to come back. It's always going to haunt them. It's always going to resurface, but now they have someone else to blame. Now they don't have to face the reality that this is a problem that they have that they need to deal with. They can just blame it on you. They can devalue you. They can project it onto you, and then they don't have to deal with it. When you enter the devaluation stage of a narcissistic relationship, you've in a sense broken a promise that you didn't know you made. You, whether or not you were aware of it, promised to the narcissist that you were going to make all of their bad feelings go away forever, and that you were going to admire and adore them unconditionally until the end of time. This is a promise that even if you knew you were making, you still could not keep. This is impossible to do. You cannot make a narcissist's problems go away like this because you're not the narcissist. You can't solve someone else's emotional problems. But this is how the narcissist is going to perceive it. They're going to feel as though they've been tricked or duped somehow. They're going to feel like they bought a Rolls Royce and then they got the car home and realized that it was really just a regular Toyota or Honda, even though in their mind they paid for and were promised a Rolls Royce. They feel like the victim in this, and that's why they can become so hostile and angry towards you. They feel like you've let them down. And when this results in them emotionally or physically abusing you, they feel justified in that abuse because they feel like they've been wronged. So when they start abusing you in this devaluation stage, they feel like you deserve it. And that's why they have no empathy for you. And that's why they won't listen to you, why they are unmoved by your tears or your pain, because they feel like what you've done is 100 times worse than anything that they could now do to you. And when you start trying to call them out on this behavior, when you complain about the way you're being treated, and when you threaten to leave them, this just adds insult to injury for them. They feel like, how dare you? You're the one that let me down. You're the one that is such a huge disappointment to me. And now you are complaining? You want to leave? You don't like the way I'm treating you when you're the one that's broken all your promises? You're the one that tricked me and lied to me and made me think that you were this awesome, amazing, perfect person? It's helpful to understand that when you as the victim enter into this stage, it's extremely confusing. It's very disorienting and confusing, but it's also confusing for the narcissist. The narcissist doesn't really understand why this is happening, and they have to look for reasons. They have to make sense out of it to themselves, and they are never going to make sense out of it in a way that reflects reality. They're never going to actually figure out what's really going on because it's really intolerable for them to look at the truth in this, because the truth would put accountability on them. It would force them to take responsibility for their own emotions and their own behavior. So in their confusion, they will look for reasons that can explain this. This is why they can start nitpicking you, why they can start criticizing you and insulting you, because they're looking for reasons that explain how this is your fault, how you're the one that's let them down. And they can really come up with absolutely ridiculous things. Maybe they can complain about your cooking, or maybe the way that you cut your hair, or maybe you gained weight or you lost weight, even if you didn't gain or lose weight. You know, they could just start making things up or imagining things. Maybe they can start telling you that you're boring and you didn't used to be boring. You used to be so exciting and now all you want to do is sit around and watch TV. When maybe in reality, if you try to suggest going out and doing something, maybe they're the one that actually wants to sit and watch TV. Or maybe they will complain that you never listen, or that you're not affectionate anymore, or that you never want to talk or spend time together or whatever. It could really be anything. And depending on your own confidence levels and your own emotional boundaries, this can really do a number on you, because they can get very creative and they can start nitpicking things that maybe you are already a little bit sensitive about. And this can unfortunately convince you that it really is your fault, that they really have lost their positive feelings for you because you are now boring or overweight or a bad cook or a boring conversationalist or whatever, that it really is your fault. And then this can cause you to start trying harder to do whatever it is you're being criticized for. And of course, that's not gonna solve the problem, because that wasn't the problem to begin with. And so for you, the victim, this can cause you to get stuck on this hamster wheel of trying and trying and trying to solve these imaginary problems that the narcissist is blaming everything on, to no avail. And you will exhaust yourself and just end up completely, utterly confused with a feeling of helplessness and in a much worse space than you began. And because of all this, narcissists create a sort of self-fulfilling prophecy. When they start criticizing you for whatever it is they pretend is causing the devaluation, when you go through this phase of trying to solve these problems, you're eventually going to get tired of this. You're eventually going to lose your trust in them, your positive regard for them. You will probably develop some resentment, and you will probably emotionally distance yourself from the relationship to some degree. And when that happens, well, now the narcissist has something real to point to. Now the narcissist can blame you for withdrawing from the relationship and no longer feeling good about it and no longer being madly in love with this person that won't stop criticizing every little thing you do. And now it really is your fault, because you're the one withdrawing from the relationship. They can actually create the illusion that this really is something that you started, that you failed, and that you created, that you are the one that destroyed this relationship, when really you're just having a natural reaction to somebody that completely adored you and admired you and now can't stand anything you do. It's completely natural to start withdrawing from a relationship like that and to start trying to protect yourself and to lose your feelings of affection for somebody that can be so cruel and cold and confusing. As I said in the beginning of the video, what I really want people that have experienced this to understand is that you did not do anything to create this. This is something that pathologically narcissistic people will always do. And it might take days, weeks, months, or even years for devaluation to set in, but it will happen. And sometimes you can go back and forth. You might be idealized one day and then devalued the next as the narcissist's mood changes. This can go back and forth, and this can go on for years. And the idealization phase can be something that you are constantly chasing, because you're under the illusion that you have control over this and that it's up to you. And I just really want people to understand that this has absolutely nothing to do with you. This is an inevitable result of the pathology of narcissism. When you are in a relationship with a pathologically narcissistic person, you are in a relationship with somebody that has impossible expectations. Not just unreasonable expectations, but impossible. expectations. You cannot fill the void in a narcissistic person. You cannot solve someone else's emotional problems, even if they expect you to. You can help a narcissist feel good about themselves and shore up their ego for a while, for a time, but you cannot keep that going forever. You just can't. And when reality caves in on them, they've got no one to blame but you, because they cannot turn it around on themselves. They cannot look in the mirror, and they cannot take accountability for their own emotional problems. You cannot cure someone else's narcissism. And I hope that you are able to learn to value yourself, to believe in yourself, to validate yourself, and to find people in your life that love you, that aren't looking to you as somebody that's going to solve problems that you can't solve, but that they are just going to love you because of who you are, and that they're not expecting you to be magical or perfect, or that you're gonna save the world. There are many people in this world that are reasonable, that are loving, and that care, and that don't expect you to do the impossible. And that's what I hope that all of us can value ourselves enough to put in the effort to find. I hope this helps. If you like this video, give it a thumbs up and comment below any ideas you have for me for future videos. And don't forget to subscribe to my channel if you like this video and you would like to see more like it in the future. Until next time, thanks. Bye.